Assalamualaikum dan salam sejahtera. Okay, so pembelajaran kita pada hari ini adalah simple interest. Okay. So first, what is the objective? So first is explain the concept of simple interest, and then you familiar with simple interest formula, and then use the simple amount formula to calculate the present and future values of some investment. Okay, so investment pelaburan, so masyarakat dalam pelaburan, so dia akan dapat interest apa semua, so pada masa akan datang berapa duit korang. And then understand for concept of exact simple interest, ordinary simple interest, exact time and approximate time, and understand banker's rule. Okay, so hari ni kita belajar sampai yang ni je. Okay, so next, okay, so introduction. Okay, so interest, what is interest actually? Okay, so interest can become two. First is money earned and money paid. Okay, so money earned ni when certain money is invested or deposited. Okay, so bila kita buat pelaburan, okay, ataupun deposit duit ni dekat dalam bank, so kita akan dapat interest. Okay, tapi deposit kat bank ni biasa interest sangat-sangat rendah, sikit sangat. Okay, okay, so for example, okay, so now we deposit 1,000, and then at the end of 1 year, after 1 year, the money become 1,500. So the extra 500 is interest earned to us. Okay, so interest yang kita dapat. Okay, so next, so this one is money paid. So money paid ni when certain money is borrow. Okay, so bila kita pinjam. Okay, so now let's say borrow 1,000, and then after 1 year, so we need to pay back 1,800. Okay, so kira-kira jumlah yang kita bayar selepas tahun adalah 1,800. Okay, so meaning that extra 800 is the interest that we paid. Okay, that we paid to the bank. Okay, so bermaksud kat sini interest tu adalah interest yang bank tu terima lah. Kita yang bagi bank tu untung. Okay. Okay, so next, first formula. Okay, so simple interest formula. Okay, so macam tadi, bila kita buat hutang ataupun buat pelaburan, kita akan dikenakan interest. Okay, so pelaburan kita dapat interest. Okay, so kalau buat hutang, kita dikenakan interest. Kita memberi interest kepada pihak bank. Okay, so next, how to calculate the simple interest. Okay, so macam mana kita nak kira simple interest tu? Okay, so the formula is I equal to PRT. Okay, so what is I? Jumlah interest tu lah. So R is rate of simple interest, and T is term in years. Okay, time, not term. Macam mana boleh term ni? So time in years. Okay, so masa kita buat pelaburan ataupun buat pinjaman. Okay, so sentiasa dalam tahun. Okay, so P is principal or original amount. Okay, so ni modal lah, principal modal ataupun duit yang kita pinjam. Okay, okay, so simple interest is used primarily for short loans and investment. Okay, so pinjaman jangka pendek dan pelaburan jangka pendek. Okay, so interest is computed on the original principal during the whole term of the loan. Okay, so dia punya interest ni sentiasa dikalkulate daripada original principal lah, so modal yang asal. Okay, so nanti kalau compound interest, so interest tu dia akan dikira daripada modal dan interest yang sebelum ni, dan dia akan sentiasa berkembang, interest pun akan bertambah. Okay, so next example. Okay, so Ali invested 5,000 in bank for 3 years. Okay, so time dia dah ada 3 years. Invested 5,000. So this one is P. T is equal to 3, and earning a simple interest rate of 7.5% a year. So this one is R. Okay, so find the simple interest earned. Okay, so cari interest yang diterima. Okay, so using the formula, I is equal to PRT, so P5000, R is 0.075, so 7.5% ni convert into decimal, and then T is 3, okay. So kira. Okay, so 5000 times by 0.075 and then times by 3. So the answer is RM 1125. Okay. So next B. So Fiona borrow some money for 18 months. So 18 months, this one is time, at 12% simple interest. So this one, interest rate R, which is equal to 0.12. If she paid 1530 in interest, okay, so 1530 in interest, how much did she borrow? So she borrow. So borrow maksudnya dia nak cari P, sebab kat sini dia dah ada interest. Interest dia adalah 1530. Yang ni kadar interest, which is 0.12, okay. So 18 months time. Okay, so time sekarang, time dia dalam bulan kan. So kalau dalam bulan, kita kena ubah dalam tahun, which is 18 divide by 12. So 18 divide by 12 is 1.5. Okay, so I equal to PRT. So put I is 1530. P we don't know because we need to find P. R is 0.12 and T is 1.5. Okay, so P is equal to, ini semua ni darab kat sini, semua ni. So balik bahagi 1530 divide by 0.12 times by 1.5. Okay, so the answer is RM 8500. Okay, so next see, at what rate of simple interest will 1200 accumulate interest of 72 ringgit. So interest of, so one is I in 6 month. So 6 month ni adalah T, okay. So 1200 ni apa? So dia kata 100 akan mengumpulkan interest sebanyak 72 ringgit. So ni adalah dia punya pokok dia, iaitu ialah principal modal. Dia nak rate of simple interest. So dia suruh cari R. Okay, so next T 6 months, so convert into year, 6 divided by 12, which is equal to 0.5. Okay, so interest 72, I is 72 equal to PRT, so P1200, R we don't know because we need to find R, and then T is 0.5, okay. Okay, so sini darab dan sini pun darab. Okay, so korang boleh darabkan 1200 dengan 0.5. So 72 equal to 600 times by R. Okay, so R is equal to 72 divided by 600. So the answer is 0.12. Okay, so this one in decimal, so convert into percent times by 100 percent. Okay, so times by 100% become 12%. Okay, so next, ada ruang kosong rupanya. Okay, so next simple amount. Simple amount, so simple amount is maturity value, which is principal plus by interest, iaitu modal tambahkan dengan interest. Okay. So principal plus by interest. Okay. So korang boleh pakai formula ni, or you can use this formula. So kat sini ditunjuklah macam mana dapat formula ni. So formula of interest is equal to PRT. So P plus PRT, and here we have P, here also P. Okay, so factor out. So P here, and here become 1, and here become R plus T. Therefore we have the formula of S is equal to P times 1 plus RT. Ataupun boleh pakai S is equal to principal plus interest. Ini yang konsep tadi kan, ini konsep asal dia. So yang dalam kotak ni untuk memudahkan, ada R, ada T, ada P, terus kira. Tak payah nak kira I dulu, lepas tu tambah P. Okay, example. Okay, so tadi kita ada S is equal to P1 plus RT. Okay, so a sum of 20,000 is invested. 20,000 dilaburkan. So bermaksud this one is P for 6 years 9 month. Okay, so this one is T. In a bank earning a simple interest rate of 4%. So this one is R. Find the simple amount and the interest earned at the end of the investment period. Okay. Okay, so T is 6 years 9 month. Okay, so 9 bulan ni kena ubah dalam bentuk tahun. So therefore T is equal to 6 plus by 9 months. So 9 divided by 12. Okay, so 9 bahagi 12, 0.75. So you will have 6.75. So to find the simple amount, S is equal to P 20,000 times by 1 plus RT. So R divided by 100, 0.04. Okay, so 4% divided by 100 is 0.04. And then times by T, so which is 6.75. Okay, so therefore you will have the answer is 25,400. Okay, so next find the interest. Okay, so dia nak dua, satu simple amount, satu interest. So I is equal to PRT, ataupun korang boleh pakai 25,400 minus by 20,000. R 0.04, T equal to 6.75. Okay, so which is equal to RM 5,400. Or you can calculate by 25,400 minus by 20,000 pun sama jawapan dia. Okay. Okay, so next question. Okay, so a sum of 10,800 is deposited. Ni deposited, so this one adalah modal principal P. Okay, so in a bank earnings simple interest of 3.5% per year. Okay, so this one is R. Okay, so R convert into decimal 0.035. So find the amount in the account after 9 months. So this one is T. Okay, so T from months convert into years, so 9 divided by 12, which is equal to 0.75. Okay, so next find the amount. So amount is, ni adalah S lah. So S is equal to P, which is 10,800, 1 plus RT. So R is 0.035, T is 0.75. Okay, so the answer is RM 11,083.50. Okay. Okay, so next, Miss Lin deposited 7,500. Okay. So 7,500 value for value for P, modal dia. Okay, so principal in a bank. So after 10 years, so this one become time T. Her deposit become 11,250. Okay, so daripada 7,500 menjadi 11,250. So bermaksud yang ni akan jadi S. Sebab dia tak bagi tahu ni interest. Okay. So tak nampak, tak ada perkataan interest pun kat sini. So ni bukan interest, ni adalah S. Okay, so find the rate of interest given. Okay, so find the rate of interest given. Yang ni dia suruh cari R. Okay, so cari R. Okay, so masukkan dalam formula S. S is equal to P1 plus RT. Okay, so S is 11,250, P is 7,500 times by 1 plus RT. So R tak tahu, T is 10. So 10 R. Okay. So R times by 10, which is 10 R. Okay. So next, you will have 1 plus 10 R. So this one, here is multiplication, bring to the here become divide. 11,250 divide by 7,500. Okay, so what is the answer? Okay, jap kiri dulu. Okay, so 11,250 divide by 7,500. Okay, so equal to 1.5. Next, this one bring to the right, so you will have 10R equal to 1.5 minus 1, which is 0.5. And then R equal to 0.5 divided by 10, which is equal to 0.05. Okay, so and then convert into percent times by 100%. So the answer is 5%. Okay, so next question. Okay, so Adam deposited 4,500. Okay. Okay, so he deposited 4,500. Okay, so this one become P. Okay, jap. Okay, so this one become P in a bank earning simple interest of 6.5%. Okay, so this one become R. And after 2 years, he deposited another amount of 3,300. Ni P lagi satu lah. P2. So, this one P1. Okay. So, in the same account, find the accumulated amount and the total interest after 5 years. So, selepas 5 tahun. Okay. Okay, so, kita buat timeline sikit. Okay, so first deposited 4,500, and second after 2 years, so need 2 years, deposit another 3,300. Okay, in the same account. So find the accumulated amount and the total interest after 5 years. So selepas 5 tahun daripada awal sampai sini. Total ni 5 tahun. So this one 3 years. So S here equal to 1 and I here also equal to 1. So berapa S dia dan berapa I? Okay. Okay, so ni kita kena buat 2 lah. So yang pertama first, 4P equal to 4,500. So we have S1 is equal to 1,500 times by 1 plus RT. So R is 0.065 times by T. So from 4,500 until the end is 5 years times by 5. Okay, so for this one, you have the answer is 5,962.5. And then for the second principle, okay, so we have 3,300 times by 1 plus 0.065. Okay, so yang 3,300 ni tempoh masa dia untuk sampai ke hujung adalah 3 tahun times by 3. Okay, so you will have berapa? Okay, so you will have 3,943.50. Okay, so therefore total S is equal to 5,962.50 plus by 3,943.5. So the answer is RM 9,906 ringgit. Okay. Ya, apa hal bawah ni? Okay, so next interest. To find the interest. So to find the interest, so principal dia ada 2, 4,500 dan 3,300. So dekat ujung ni jumlah duit dia adalah 9,906. Okay. So S tadi adalah principal dengan interest. Okay, so therefore to find the interest, S ni kita kena tolakkan dengan principal dia, which is 3,300 and minus by 4,500. Okay. 3,300 and 4,500. Okay, so therefore the total interest that he earned is 2,106. Okay, so next question. Okay, so Adam deposited ni yang sama ni. Soalan sama dengan atas ni Adam. Tersalin 2 kali pula. Okay. So next, Mariana. So Mariana needed some money to start up her bakery. Okay, so she borrowed 12,000. Okay, so pinjam 12,000. So ni akan jadi P dia. Okay, so for 30 months and paid back 14,250 at the end of the loan period. Okay, so tempoh masa dia 30 bulan. So what was the interest rate? So dia suruh cari R. Okay, so this one for, so jumlah bayar balik semua sekali adalah 14,250. Okay, so ni termasuk interest semua sekali, principal dan interest, which means this one is S. Okay, so 14,250 is equal to, okay, so formula dia S is equal to P1 plus RT. Okay, so substitute S, 14,250, principal is 12,000, 1 plus R is tak tahu, and T is 30 months. So months change into year, 30 divided by 12. Lupa nak tukar siap-siap. So yang ni ubah ke sini jadi bahagi. So 14,250 divided by 12,000 5,000 is equal to 1 plus 30 divided by 12, 2.5. So 2.5 R. Okay, so therefore you will have 1 plus 2.5 R is equal to 14,250 divided by 12,000, which is equal to 1.1875. Okay, so therefore 2.5 R is equal to 1.1875 minus 1, which is 0.1875. So R is equal to 0.1875 divided by 2.5. So the answer is 0.075, and then convert into percent times by 100%. So the answer is 7.5%. So next, so last, okay, yang ni kita akan sambung kelas akan datang. So Samsul took out 30,000 construction loan. Loan ni pinjaman lah. So pinjaman maksudnya dia pinjam lah 30,000 kan. So ni dia punya principal to renovate a house. So the loan rate is 8.3% simple interest per year. Okay, so this one ada perkataan rate, walaupun loan rate, so this one is R, okay, which is 0.083, convert into decimal divide by 100, and will be repeat back in 6 month. So akan dibayar balik dalam tempoh 6 bulan. So T is equal to 6 divide by 12, which is equal to 0.5 years. Okay, so convert bulan kepada tahun bahagi dengan 12. So how much is he paid back? So berapa banyak dia kena bayar balik? So mean that this one is S. Okay, so jumlah yang dia kena bayar balik, iaitu jumlah yang dia pinjam bersama dengan interest, which is S. Okay, so S is equal to P times by 1 plus RT. So principal is 30,000. And then 1 plus R is 0.083 and T is 0.5. Okay, so the answer is RM 31,245. Okay, jap kira balik. So betul. Okay, so inilah jumlah yang dia kena bayar balik, modal yang dia pinjam dan interest sekali. Okay. Okay, so our lesson today stop until here. Okay, so next time we will continue on 4 basic concept in daily interest. Okay, so ni macam mana kita nak, how we want to convert into years. Okay, so nak ubah hari kepada tahun. Dia ada 4 konsep. Okay, okay, so that's all. Thank you and Assalamualaikum. See you again later.